It's my Feel Good Breakfast Show.
A Feel Good Breakfast Show. This is Espresso, and we're live on Three. Thanks so much for joining us this morning. Well, from amazing stuff in our kitchen that we've done earlier to some entertainment news. Zoe girl, what you got?
What's the latest?
So I've got some news for us. You know, there's been a lot of umming and ahhing who's going to take over the James Bond role after Daniel Craig. Well, it seems now the author of the Bond series books, the latest one, Anthony Horowitz, he caused quite a raucous online, because I mean, we all know Idris Elba, we all like the idea of having him, but he went out yesterday and he said, you know, Idris was too street to play Bond.
What now, exactly do you mean by that statement?
So to read his words, I'm upset.
That pushes my buttons.
Yeah, so his exact words were, for me, Idris Elba is a bit too rough to play the part. It's not a colour issue. I think he's probably a bit too street to play Bond. It's a question of being suave.
But not too street to play Madiba.
Yeah.
I mean, come on.
But then a lot of people were not taking this. And he went later on, he since then has apologised and he says, I'm really sorry for the comments about Idris Elba caused offence. That wasn't my intention. Clumsily, I chose the word street as Elba's gritty portrayal of DCI John Luther.
Yeah.
But I mean, you know, if you think about it, at the end of the day, he is an actor.
He played a role. And that Luther character is like psychotic and he's mad and he's a crazy lawman. We get that. It's a character. I would have loved to have seen Idris as James Bond.
Yeah, I hate the beef, eh? They should just give him the role.
I think so too. He's very sophisticated, yes. So also another one, Kylie Jenner. She's showing us a different side to her. She's not just your
physically
reality.
Physically or emotionally?
Nah. Well, online. Online she is. So what she's done now, she's launched her anti-bullying campaign and she's using the hashtag I am more than. So what she's going to do is people that's been victims of bullying, she spends some time with them and she really feels like, you know, it's necessary to use her public platform to share their stories. So she's really doing something incredible.
What I love is you're seeing so many celebrities come out now. We've seen it happen big time in the English context, come out now and show their own stories of bullying as well and how much it is happening to everyone. So people going on to become these icons of style that were at one stage bullied. So it's good that this is now open platform for everyone to talk
Definitely.
About.
Definitely. Well, we should be using our talent for good, and it's really awesome that even the Kardashians are jumping on this bandwagon and using their status for good. Well, you know what? Something that is really great, guess who is coming to visit? Yes, if you haven't heard the news yet, well, you better make sure that you put that cup of coffee down just for a second, because one of the hottest names in comedy and in film in the world is coming to South Africa, or coming to Africa, rather, for the first time ever. It's none other than Kevin Hart.
Woo!
Yes.
Yeah.
Well, Katleho's excited, so is the rest of the team. He's bringing his Kevin What Now? comedy brought to you by Premium Cider in partnership with Real Concerts. And you can check the social media pages for more info. The South African leg of the tour, it kicks off in March with shows in Cape Town, Durban, and tickets are not available just yet, but it will be available in CompuTickets. So, of course, Kevin Hart, kindly brought to you by Savannah. He is coming to South Africa. So it might just change up your march for next year.
Oh, keeping it very dry indeed. But he's certainly, he is a hot topic at the moment.
Yeah, for sure.